Let's hear the latest stories making headlines amongst the Filipino community.
Yesterday, detectives...
We begin in Daytona Beach, Florida, where 2 months after the fatal police shooting of a Phil-Am man, his family is seeking justice. On February 9, authorities reportedly performed a traffic stop to take Randy Lansang into custody, boxing his vehicle in so that he could not leave. Four officers opened fire. Lansang allegedly appeared to have a loaded gun inside the vehicle. Authorities say the Phil-Am had an extensive criminal history, which included assault and burglary. The Daytona Beach Police released the body camera footage a day after the incident. Lansang's family believes he fully complied with the orders of police officers.
We believe that he was cooperative and he did have his hands up. Because like if you hear on the body cam that they did show, you could hear him say, like, "I have my hands up."
Lansang's mother, Annabel Moctator, has filed a lawsuit against the city of Daytona Beach. Let's go to Canada, where the province of British Columbia is fast-tracking the pathway for thousands of internationally educated nurses, or IENs, so that they can start working in hospitals as soon as possible. More than $12 million in funding will be used in part to launch a triple-track assessment process where only one application is needed to assess if an IEN can be a registered nurse, a licensed practical nurse, or a healthcare aide. $9 million from the funding will be used to offer bursaries to 1,500 IENs to help pay for the costs of assessment, skills evaluation, language, and education.
We've taken a number of steps to streamline the regulatory assessment. It's quite complicated to remove financial barriers by providing bursaries, also to add personal supports to help internationally educated nurses navigate through the system.
Here is Mercito Hesta!
And finally in sports, it's been over 2 years, but lightweight contender Mercito No Mercy Hesta is looking to get back on track. The Mandawi City native faces Joel Diaz Jr. on Thursday. Diaz holds a 26-win and 2-loss record. Both fighters hit the scales on Wednesday. Hesta came in at 134.8 pounds, while Diaz tipped the scale at 134.6 pounds.
Super excited. You know, it's been a while. And coming back, that no problem with my weight. I feel good. I have a good camp, so I'm super excited. I just can't wait.
Hesta has a 32-win and 3-loss record. The fight will take place at the Fantasy Springs Event Center in Indio, California on Thursday's Golden Boy Fight Night on DAZN and will be streamed on the DAZN app.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to you guys for the rundown.